an expert in medicine. I'm not a doctor. I just thought I'd say that right off the bat. I do have a personal knowledge of nootropics, and I'm hoping that I can share some of that with you guys so you're more aware of them, because they're interesting little chemicals. Okay, so nootropics. You have natural source and more lab-oriented stuff, and both of them are categorized together. So, you know, it's all about brain function. So we get cognition, memory, intelligence, motivation, attention, and concentration. So basically any drug that affects those aspects of the brain, and potentially even a little bit outside, like secondary effects, can be termed a nootropic. Okay, so how do they work? And what is like going on with this stuff? Does anybody here have a background in neuroscience or brain chemistry? Anybody here have a biology background? No? Okay. So brain function, basically what you have going on, and I might go into it a little bit later if I have time, is you have like sensory reception, you have the brain functions going on, then there's critical stages where that information is adjusted. So you have what's called, like, I could pronounce this wrong, but amygladia. It's the point that affects sort of your emotional reception, categorizes important emotional responses. And you have like the frontal lobe, hippocampus, all these different areas of the brain. They interplay in how you store information and how that information is called upon. Neurotransmitters is another thing. So has anybody heard of neurotransmitters before? You know, what about androgen receptors? Yeah, okay. So it's all about what here we have, overall body health, oxygen supply, stimulus response, and then your neurotransmitters, enzymes, and hormones. So all that stuff affects how well your brain functions. Okay, so as I was just saying, yeah, long-term memory, perspective, retrospective, so all these different types. And depending on what part of the brain and how it's called upon and how old it is, you'll have different effects from that. Okay, so I just wanted to say that there's lots of money in nootropics. Like most of the pharmaceuticals, there's lots and lots of money being spent on it, especially as people are aging. The reason why nootropics are very important for the aging population, or what is it, geriatrics or geriatrics, is because a lot of these brain functions are being deteriorated over time. And there's a reason for that, which I'll get into later. And these drugs often will mitigate that. Everybody knows Alzheimer's disease. These are really big into that. So $30 billion industry in the US, and then anti-aging, $1 billion. So that's, you know, a substantial amount of money. Okay, so health fads. I'm not a charlatan, I'm not trying to sell snake oil, but other people may be. So the media is a big part of this, and the media can be really good in getting health benefits out to the population, which is really good, but they can also give some false information or information that isn't necessarily fully scientific or not fully studied through medicine fully. So there's lots of reports. You can see reports saying blah, 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 this is really good for you, but its proven effects may not be very well known. On the other hand, it could be a really good thing too. So if you see something about it, you should look into it more closely and research it. So some of these have results, some of them don't. I can say that, do they affect your brain and how it functions? They do, some of them. So don't think that none of these work. Even the stuff that isn't lab processed, like actual chemicals, like drugs, they still have an effect, even if they're natural source stuff. I can vouch for this. Even if it's a minor effect, it's still a noticeable effect. Oh, I skipped this one. Oh no. Okay, where do they come from? Joke here, France, sometimes everything comes from France. Okay, and these dietary supplements and labs. For drugs, you have some really powerful ones, like modafinil. This stuff is for narcolepsy, so it keeps you awake for like a whole day, or longer, sometimes. So if you're testing these things, make sure you know what you get, because even if they're, some of these drugs, they may not necessarily be legal, or they may require a prescription, but sometimes they have different names, and customs doesn't necessarily get all the stuff. So if you order something online, for instance, and it could come through, even if it's illegal, or it's a like prescription drug, and you may not know that if you don't research it properly. So be aware there are some drugs with very noticeable effects that are designed for more serious health issues. Okay, so common nootropics. We have like omega-3 fatty acids. Anybody see omega-3 eggs? You know, like they're in the the grocery store. And yeah, caffeine. So caffeine's very common. Like, anybody here drinking coffee right now or plans to later? You know, like, that's a nootropic. And then, yeah, they're called xanthines. Like, there's lots of xanthine drugs that are basically, they are wakeful. Well, they don't let you necessarily notice that you're tired, so that's another neurochemical response. So everybody probably knows that. Yeah, antioxidants, which are also fairly well known, I think, now. Like, it's one of those health fads that came along, but antioxidants are good. Nicotine, cigarettes. Cigarettes aren't seen as good, but nicotine itself is dangerous because you can overdose on it, but it also promotes your body's neurochemical response. I don't know too much about nicotine, actually. But it's addictive to it. Okay. And then you have stuff like phenols and isoflavones. This is stuff that maybe you've heard of if you're into health and nutrition. I am, but I haven't really heard too much about them. But they're in everything, you know, like, you get them everywhere. So they're another source of nootropics. Okay, so ractams. Who here has heard of ractams? Okay, so basically these things are praised for most nootropic peoples. Looking at them more closely, they're seen as safe, but they're not actually all legal in Canada. I think some of them are actually banned in Canada. Some of them are okay, some of them aren't. In the US, it's a whole different story. Most of this stuff in the US is totally legal. It's over the counter, so you don't need to worry about it. But in Canada, there's some more Health Canada restrictions on what's available and what's not, for various reasons, and I don't want to go into that. But we have stuff like androgenic, dopamine. All this stuff is saying how it's affecting you. So you have to be, like, they call them stacking. So you have a bunch of different nootropics and you combine them all together into a giant drug stack. And it's supposed to be a better overall benefit because you have one nootropic that affects one aspect, another nootropic that affects another aspect. So you actually have to combine stuff because you can have potentially cancellations on how this, all this stuff is interacting, which I'll get into a little bit later if I have time. Okay, so show and tell. Okay, so these are all stuff that I have. And I'm gonna see which ones I can go through with the time I have. Okay, so huperzine A. Okay, this is actually touted as an Alzheimer's treatment. So it's China, it's been clinically tested in China, whatever that means to anybody, and it's actually been proven very effective. This does. You can take one of these, I can pass them around, no, just kidding. You can take one of these, and then, you know, a little while later, you'll notice that you're starting to think a little bit different. It's like, I'm not sure if anybody's ever been aware of how people talk about marijuana, where, you know, it's sort of that flashback effect, where it's like double thought, where you can actually recall, it's recall. You can recall things a lot better. So it's like a flashback effect on your memory. And there's no real side effects at a low dose that I've noticed, and there can be, so be careful about this stuff too, because there's side effects potentially too, but I haven't experienced any that I'm aware of. Alkar. Alkar is actually touted more for, in the bodybuilding community, for acetyl L-carnitine, for various health effects. It's called a super antioxidant, and what's special about this is that, I think I have another slide for this, but it's like blood-brain barrier, so it passes through the blood-brain barrier, which I'm not sure if anybody's aware of this, but you have like a fluid barrier sort of between your brain and your blood supply, I guess. Some stuff, I guess, can go through this blood-brain barrier, other stuff cannot. So Alkar is one of the things that can go through the blood-brain barrier, so it has more of an effect, I guess you would say, than things that couldn't. So, this is really good stuff. So if you're looking into it, you need to look into it carefully, because of the potential legalness of it. But it has powerful effects. But other people, some studies have said it doesn't do anything. But be your own judge. Okay, so as I was just saying, there's blood-brain barrier. I can skip the slide since I don't have the time. So hormones do matter. There's something called the parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system. So how the body responds to stress, for instance. Something's called cortisol. So it's I believe a hormone. And it regulates your blood sugar, but it also promotes stress. So basically the more cortisol you have in your body, potentially the more breakdown you have. So if you have a whole bunch of cortisol, what starts happening is what's called atrophy.